Fatima Ali Salam has lived in Boston's Mattapan neighborhood for close to 50 years, and she's noticed one big change.
There were significantly more trees. There were more streets with trees from storms, from just being not maintained, as well as development. We've lost canopy.
A stark contrast between neighborhoods and towns just a few short miles away.
Walking down Beacon Street in Brookline, right near Coolidge Corner, I was dumbstruck by the number of additional new trees actually planted on the sidewalk. Along with a clean, well-maintained, federally paid-for light rail trolley system right down the center of the street. I thought that was very interesting, that you could have plenty of commerce, but also make sure that you had adequate tree canopy, well-maintained sidewalks, well-maintained streets. It wasn't a competition. The thought had been put into it.
In Mattapan, one of Boston's heat islands, greenery is sparse and heat-absorbing concrete is abundant. In fact, most of Boston's heat islands are in historically lower-income neighborhoods, such as Roxbury and Chinatown. Many experts believe the practice of redlining, refusing to offer mortgages or investments in primarily minority neighborhoods, has created these conditions.
Things like what neighborhoods got the best sports facilities and the larger parks, and all of those decisions added up to make those communities less safe, and it made the economic picture even worse for them. It's sad to see that we are still now, 50, 70 years later, seeing the impacts of those decisions.
When it comes to heat islands, the impacts include chronic conditions such as asthma on the hottest days, heat stroke, and in the worst case, death.
They've got to speak up.
Rhianne Gibson is the senior research fellow at the Conservation Law Foundation. She studies the relationship between urban development and community health.
Until we put in more investment into those communities and really build them and design them the same way we might design the suburbs, you're still gonna see those health impacts trickling down to the communities.
And rather than put in topsoil, they just poured cement.
Jamaica Plain resident Richard Peretz says that cement solved traffic issues in his Hyde Square neighborhood, but it made the area hotter.
I don't think it was deliberate. I think it was a devastating oversight. And I think if the neighborhood was more affluent and more enfranchised, the oversight wouldn't have been allowed. It's just a shocking example. I mean, I hate to even say these words, but it's just, the evidence is stark. It's elitist racism.
Peretz is the design chair of Three Squares, a nonprofit that helps JP businesses along Center Street.
Cement and certainly blacktop radiate heat. They absorb heat, and they hold it and they radiate it back. So if this were not a hard surface, cement, and it was soil or green shrubbery or trees, it would be cooler.
Parrott says green space or even soil in this sea of cement and asphalt would help make Hyde Square more desirable for businesses and future residents.
You'd want to be here. You'd want to be in Hyde Square. The businesses benefit, and an economically disadvantaged community is given that chance to meet the rising standards of other neighborhoods, which is green space.
This is really eye-opening. So what can residents do to expand green space?
Yeah, I mean, she stressed that residents must really help kind of conceptualize, expand green space, and have opportunities for formally owning or leasing land in the community for their use. She says this will allow residents to have ownership over what happens in their communities and will contribute to better health. And we've seen that link many times between health and especially among children.
All right, great, Mike, thank you. To cool temperatures on the ground, consider the temperature on the roof.